This is Amethyst Lunatari here with a bit of bad news, but hopefully just temporary bad news. Starfield. This disk that I have it on, which one runs Windows 10. For those who don't know, I have a dual boot system. I have Windows 7 on here and Windows 10 here, and these are just that's an external drive, and this is a recording. This is some more basically my personal stuff and all my games saved here. But anyway, this won't boot. Yes, I can access it, which is awesome, because then I might be able to find the save file, right? So it won't boot, but I can access it. All right, so basically I have to boot into Windows 10 to play Starfield. It's not going to run properly under Windows 7, and plus I'd have to completely install it as well, and you know, while running Windows 7, and yeah, gets a little confusing sometimes. You know, so you remember that Starfield and Cyberpunk 2077 are on Windows 10, and the rest are on Windows 7 for now, anyway. But this won't boot. I'm getting a check disk errors. Yeah, something with the master boot record, I believe it's called. The MBR. So I have a few options. But the only problem is I can't find the save files for Starfield. I've looked all over and I've seen quite a few different ideas of where these save files could be. Okay. So I have the address bar that would be up here off screen. It's really not a good idea to show your computer username. So anyway, here we are in the Windows 10 drive, and we are here under users and the username, which I will not tell you, and right, so here's documents. This thing, one said it was in users, documents, my games, Starfield, saves. So here's users, documents. I don't have my games. I can't access these anyway. Unless I had to be booted into the system to access that. Alright, so they're thinking, well, maybe they mean documents as far as my documents. Can't get into that unless I boot the disk. Apparently. If there's another way around, please let me know. plus, it's really helpful because I never added Starfield. That was my bad. I never added Starfield to my my backups. I have backups to that exterior drive that I showed you, which has all the all the latest game saves and stuff, and it just backs up once a week. I can't back this up. I can't find it. So, and I run the program. The program runs from 7, so I guess I have to run it on 10 also, if it's even compatible. Thinking it should be. But anyway, I also have this saved games, but there's nothing in there. Right. So that's that. Yeah. Program file, Steam user data. I just have this, which is from maybe when I installed Starfield. There's nothing in here. I've looked through all these and there's nothing that would that I would think would be any kind of save files. Right? It's just remote cache. Whatever that is. Saves? Wait a second. Oh, that might be it then. Maybe. Are these my saves? Are these my Starfield saves? State modified. Exit save. When did I last? When did I last play? That's a good question. Let me check some. Okay. So here's get a little peek behind the scenes. Here's my original recordings. Not the rendered recording or anything. Or edited. These are the pure raw videos. Created May 31st, 2024. Modified, I don't know. So, yeah, 2:57 a.m. Oh, yeah, I looked here, too, and I'm hiding the username again, which is under users, my username, app data, local low. So some Steam stuff here, but, yeah, it's not in here. It's not under Microsoft. Unless this is it. Maybe it's under Microsoft. Right? That's around the same time. So at least it's promising. I've got ideas. So this is under local low Microsoft CryptNet URL cache content. So it might be this. Right, that's the data file there. And what else? Right, it could also be this. Your 3:04 a.m. SFS file. These actually say save. Alright, because I always manually save. So I figure here's the auto save, here's my manual save, and here's the save just when I quit out the game. Yeah, I'm going to back up those two things. I'm going to hold on to the disk, absolutely. I was thinking of bringing it down and getting it the data mined off of it, or maybe the boot record repaired or something like that. But it's probably going to cost me more money in the long run than just getting a new one. I still have access to the Windows that I bought. So I'll reinstall Windows and then reinstall Starfield and then plug in these saves and hope they work. Other than that, it's just a waiting game because I'm going to check to see if this drive is covered under warranty. I'm pretty sure that time has expired or I didn't get an extended warranty. Because I have a whole bunch of drives and I've got extended warranties on a few of them. And then I kind of stopped doing it because, how many extended warranties can one person have? So, yeah, I'm having a lot of problems with the drive. Every time check disk starts up and it's actually repairing. It looks like it's repairing registry settings. So I'm not sure what is going on with that. But the rest of the system is fine. Windows 7 working great. Some people think it's funny I still run Windows 7, but there are some emulators and games that just run better under 7. I'm talking about retro stuff, of course. So that's why I have that. I mean, if it was up to me, I'd still have Windows XP as a dedicated retro gaming computer. Pretty obscure to put Steam user data and then this number, remote saves. And this seems likely. So yeah, just letting you know, there's going to be a pause until my new disk gets here and it's possible it might be a couple weeks, guys. It's possible it might be a few weeks because if I have to buy, out of pocket, a new drive, then, I don't know, I'm kind of broke right now. I'm trying to fix my vehicle, which is costly, and it's coming near the end of the month, and rent is going to be due. So, I don't think I should shell out $100 until I have my vehicle back, which should probably be tomorrow as this is uploaded, Monday, and rent is paid, and I have some medical bills to pay as well. So yeah, well, maybe if it's an issue with money. I have to see if I can get a refund or exchange on it, and that might take more time because I have to send it to them and they're going to look at it and everything and determine, yeah, there's something wrong with this. I don't know what the procedure is there. But yeah, I guess check my community tab. I'll keep you guys updated with how the drive situation is, the Windows 10 side drive. Otherwise, yeah, just making this video just to make you guys aware why there's no video. Everything else is going to continue as normal. I might put the book reading videos to 5 p.m. just because there's nothing else going up that day. If when there's a Starfield day, which alternates with Baldur's Gate 2. So, yeah, other than that, everything continuing as normal. And, yeah, while I'm waiting for that, I try to get, like, caught up or past all the other games I have running, which won't be too hard, because I think only Baldur's Gate 2 needs to be played now otherwise. But anyway, I apologize for the inconvenience, and I hope to see you guys somewhere. Always seek adventure.